what started, yeah, was unprecedented with myself now without having the ability to escape from this bullshit, from this torment, from this torture, sticking on a picture of Liberty with British. I felt like they were like the closest because of the language and stuff. And I turned to a new Lavrov, which was a British, yeah. British Prince Andrew and British Prince Charles, 1989. Donald Trump, all these people on picture. They complained about me with Americans, claiming even that we were only white people, that I don't like them, that I'm a racist and so on, that I don't know. The one who figured out the racism is all white Americans, Germans. They claimed that I was a racist against them. This is how it all started. Oh, the new Lavrov suggested me a new ways. The new Lavrov suggested me to, during the setups with Russians, Serbs, Slovenian people here in Slovenia, Belarus and so on, for me to rather stick to the Nazis, basically, to support the Nazi option, since I was suggested that other option is not so close to you. So this is now a whole new window they opened, yeah? So, new Lavrov, when I say new Lavrov, that was Prince Andrew. Huh? That was the assistance given to me. That is 2 years before the Soviet Union dissolved. Estonian, Baltic states, Chechen, these governments participated and observed this Russian violence that started to develop against me into greater and greater and greater form. And I really, God knows what the fuck, I don't know what the fuck went on, but this turned into a tremendous hostility. The hostility was actually unmatched, unprecedented hostility. The hostility through which probably masks were even used by the Russians to intimidate, to harass, and to what as a result had me labeled afterwards as a traitor of the Slavic people, and I don't know what, which had nothing to do with the Slavic people, but because at negotiation table it went all the way to demand for me to declare myself as the one who wants to stay in front of the Americans, British and other Germans in Yugoslavia, which I never ever did. That's because of the violence that Yugoslavia exercised against me since kindergarten. That was a very big problem for them. To declare them, not them, but to the representatives from Croatia, from Bosnia, and of course they have from Macedonia and Montenegro and so on, that regardless of the cost, there might be for Yugoslavia, because the Russians, the first thing it is, they threaten that Yugoslavia is going to fall apart if Slovenia lives, yeah? And I told them, I'm not responsible for that. What would I have to do with this? If Yugoslavia is going to fall apart because Slovenia is going to depart, become independent state, I told them, I don't actually have a problem. I told them, I don't like Yugoslavia. Yugoslavia, to me, was no good. It was a bad country. Violence that was done to me. And that is something that invigorated. Russians, the last thing the Kaczynski brothers assisted the Russian side was with what I stated them. Russians managed still to produce from me. After I rejected Bosnian, Croatian, Macedonian and other representatives in Moscow, with they started to fucking death threaten and stuff like this for the cost of life. That I don't want to have nothing to do with them, that I want Slovenia independent. And it turned literally into genetical stuff, asking me, don't you think that we are genetically closer relatives to one another in Yugoslavia more than we are to stop my demand for Slovenia to separate itself and to become independent state, is what they did. That's why they did that shit. Then you are to Italians and to the Germans and so on. That's when they lost me completely, because I lost my mind and I stated them, no, I want Slovenia independent. As a matter of fact, I am genetically not related in any way, not to the Croats, not to the Bosnian, not to any people from ex-Yugoslavia, absolutely not. Alija Izetbegović was the one who death threatened at the time, if I would even think about having Slovenia to separate itself from Yugoslavia, yeah? Very shortly after that, he was asking me for the money to rebuild TAS, Tvornica Automobila Sarajevo, where the Volkswagen was produced. This is where the war broke out and the Serbs started to murder Bosnian people. They burned them the factory. Alija Izetbegović told me at the factory where Miroslav Berger brought me, because of you, he said, because of you. Actually, he said, for you. You owe us so much and so much. I told him, I don't owe you shit. Basically, I don't owe you shit. You wanted to fucking kill me. These are the people that death threatened and wanted me dead more than Russian people, more than Serbian people. And all of a sudden were the people that deemed that I owe them money, that I owe them for reparations of this and that and so on. That's how the conflict developed, for which Alija Izetbegović apologized. He did apologize, he took responsibility for it. His son also apologized and so on. They cooked, they were very stubborn for a very long time, but you know, I was not apologetic in respect to Slovenian independence. Yeah? Kaczynski brothers, however, took this and they translated this about the genetic stuff into a total violence, total brutality against me. So it was a psychiatry immediately in the picture to like blacklisted from employment, like everything that started to destroy absolutely everything in my life. Everything went taken to the Moscow, to the hospital, and infested with lymphoma, with the cancer in a right arm and so on and so forth. Life just took like for the fucking worst time. Chinese started to support the so-called Chinese traditional medicine. And this was just like a really, really not like a black humor, you would say. Like basically butchery that the Russians exercised on me. Russians have presented, Russians wanted to turn the whole world against me. And so Russians, the first thing they did, they went through the China. And it was the president before, the Xi Jinping, whom they have used, and other people, to present me China as hostile as possible by literally stating me that if I know how great the Chinese traditional medicine is and so on. They started to teach me about the Chinese culture and stuff, which every child learned about, read about and so on. They started to tutor me about those issues, but presenting me Chinese traditional medicine as a form of healing due to cancerous wounds they would inflict on my body. And Chinese was stupid enough to take a responsibility. No, they were not stupid enough. They got a good discount, oil and all that kind of stuff, gas and minerals and all that, straight with it. It's just a partnership, and you're not a human on the picture. You're just a number. That's all the fuck I was. I was a nobody. I was just somebody that you take and you chop him in pieces, basically, and you're laughing about it. And you're presenting him issues as such, like traditional Chinese acupuncture and all these things. You're gonna be, remember what we told you about the China, you're gonna go to China and this and that, you don't wanna go to China, you don't wanna go to China. You know, this kind of issues, this is how the Chinese started to bully in 1993, while the Russians were performing on hands, surgical procedures, using a police to surgically, actually after the surgeries, they would follow up and widen these wounds, so the wounds no longer would heal. They were creating like a chronic liver, kidney, those kind of issues, for which the Germans took a really nice responsibility in 2002, stressing anger outbursts in me on how on the feet, like, let's say, you're gonna see how this is. You're gonna, they stress to the police that they have to make sure that they connect whatever is about the Chinese traditional. They already realized long time ago how certain spots on the feet are connected to the liver and to the kidney, till he's gonna feel actually the pain and suffering and this and that. Man, this is MK Ultra. If you wanna have the real taste about MK Ultra, how it all went, how this racism all started, who jump-started one and how. Because everything I had, everything that follow up afterwards, this is just continuation of what I stated. But that's basically how far I can go in this. Americans and British played with the sanity through the use of violence together with the Russians, were completely synchronized. They would, how can I express myself? Prince Andrew, who became my new Lavrov, and Prince Charles, but Prince Andrew was the one who was in charge for me all the time. He became my new Lavrov, you know. He actually, how can I say? I had no fucking idea what the fuck. I had a trouble accepting the Nazism as my way. It was not exactly given to me. This was not my view. This was really not my vision. I didn't like Nazism. It was actually Prince Andrew, whom I have repeatedly asked, during a torture, when Russians and Jews became a super active party that London dealt with, right between the Russian London was Israel, and they would make me, like, push me in a situations where I would know what the fuck they want from me, to which side they want me to deal, because some Jews were looking like a Germans and the other Jews were looking like you know, like Arab, Mid-Easterners, and they were literally using a state of Israel to play with my sanity completely, I was asking Prince Andrew repeatedly whom I should side now with the partisans or with the Nazis. And I was looking at him literally for the answer, like what the fuck is gonna say. And once I got the answer, I said, yeah, okay. Prince Andrew actually asked me, said, which one do you like better? I said, like, I like partisans. I don't know. I said, man, you tell me what the fuck, whom should I vote for? Basically, whom should I support? Which side are we supporting now? This is basically how far this fucklety fuck British violence have gone in this case. So that completely dement you, completely destroy you, completely eat your brain out. And then what they do is they just kick you in the ass and fucking die in front of the world. Make the enemy with the entire world and say, fuck you. Die over there yourself. You did this. That's all there is to it. That's how that was done. And this never ever anybody could possibly do a more detailed video on something like it took place in my life. And I told you, for every scam, for every shit, even for most critical dots on exactly how it all started in the second grade of the grammar school when I was 9 years old. And for the rest of it, you know. But remember one thing, the anger that Russians built in me cost Soviet Union fall, because the anger was so bad that the Russians who waged war against me have faced a total rage in return from my end. And very soon it was Latvia and Estonia and Lithuania and Chechnya, in several countries they have faced, because of these people that were observing, these people all participated, they faced a bloody, bloody revolt. They faced heavy weaponry and hell and fire and everything possibly the fuck you can face, with all the might and with everything they had. Whether they liked it or not, they had to recognize as independent. A bunch of countries. That's why they used to call me. That's another reason. Next to daddy, granddaddy, grand-granddaddy, dinosaur even. They used to call me a father of the Eastern Europe. The one who brought to life the entire Eastern Europe. This is who the fuck I am. So when you try some British garbage over there, get somebody with the Bentley, roll the window a quarter down, parked in the direction of the building, and you think I'm gonna approach you because you have your, fuck you, man. You know you're fucking nobody. You know you're fucking nobody. The only thing you're gonna do is you're gonna face ultimate trashing. The same like Russians did, all the way to the fucking end. We're gonna dance the grave. If I'm gonna die in this process, you have a good chances to accomplish because of what you have done here in Novo Mesto, so be it. But with exactly the way you see me today, that's exactly how you will remember what you have done to me. And basically, the people who followed my steps to freedom, they will know exactly what to expect from you. That's what you have done. That's what United States of America, France, Italy, Spain, Scandinavia, all this that they are trying to, they're gonna try to excuse all this and rationalize. You know what? Fuck you. You wanna know everything about what it was, how it was? No matter what you're gonna do, because of the amount of governance I mentioned right now, you are never gonna come with more official and efficient account of what took place than I just gave you right now. That's why Bentley is just, for what you owe me, I could buy myself a million Bentleys, basically.